Hi, I'm Will Paterson, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can create your very own business card using design trends throughout 2022 inside of Vectornator. To create a business card, it's not very difficult. In fact, the simpler, the better. So without further ado, let's get straight into the tutorial. The first thing we're going to do to create this modern, minimalistic business card design is go ahead and create a new document. Now, I've got in my custom sizes here a business card document, but what we're going to do is make our own. We're going to go to custom size, we're going to type in business card as the name of the document, and we're going to go ahead and save this as a custom template, and we just say card or business card. And in the sizing, we want to change the units to inches. Now, a standard business card size before print as designing is 3.75 by 2.5. Once we've done that, we're going to go ahead and press create. Now, this is the standard business card size before print, but we technically need to make sure that we don't design in any places that will get cut off. Because this is going to be printed, the printers like to have a place where you can cut the card. So we need to create guides in order to stop ourselves from designing in places where we know it's going to be cut off. So to create the guides, make sure you've got the rulers at the top and you can find them in the settings. And we're going to just tap at the top here with our selection tool. And we're going to come a bit further in. We're going to go in 2 points or two of these further in on each side. Okay, so there we go. We've got our card and we've got the guides in place. Depending on which printer you go to, they may have a template for you to download with guides in place already, but you can also look at the websites and it will give you all the information. What we're going to do really quick is we're going to select the top here of this card and it will go like this, and we're going to actually duplicate this. We're going to press copy and paste, and it will paste another card over here. We're going to go up to the layers, we're going to go to this card, and we're going to say card back. The reason why we're doing this is that a business card has a front and a back. Really important to have. Generally speaking, the back of a business card can be landscape or portrait, with the logo landscape or in the portrait mode. To be a bit more trendy in the year of 2022, we're going to go for a black background and go for really contrasting minimal colors. What we're going to do is create a square, and we're going to make sure there's no roundness, and we're just going to create a square all across. We're going to go to the fill, and we're going to choose this sort of dark black color, dark blue color. We don't want it to be fully black, you just want it to be dark blue. If it's fully black, it'll look a bit strange when it's printed. Once we've got this, I'm going to go to this layer here, the big rectangle, and we're going to lock it. This means that whenever I'm selecting something else, I won't be selecting the background. The next thing is to bring in some type. I'm going to bring in some type here. We're just going to scale this out, and you can't see it right now. So what we're going to do is change the type text. We're going to format, go down to text. We're going to change the fill. I'm going to choose this nice bright blue. Seems a bit bright, but in here, I'm going to be putting our logo. If you have a logo that you've already got, copy it and bring it in. But for this tutorial, I'm going to show you a placeholder with just the name logotype. So imagine this would be your real logo. I'm going to go ahead and press fit bounds to text size. And we're going to make sure that this is nice and centered by going to arrange, going to the horizontal and vertical evenness there. Now, this looks a bit boring, and we want to add some shapes and things to really show the brand behind it. We're going to do it in this sort of monochromatic way where we're using two shades. We're using the dark shade and the light shade. So what I'm going to do is really quickly with my pencil and with this teal color, the smoothness dragged all the way up, going to create some shapes like this, and we're going to just keep redoing it until we get a nice shape. That looks good. We're going to come back over here, making sure that we get them well within the guides there. Boom. We've got some shape there. The reason why I've done it to top left to the bottom right is because it gives a nice balance overall. So imagine your logo being there, and then you've got these shapes. You can add any shape that you like though. The real trendiness comes from the positioning of the logo and also the colors that are used. The next thing we're going to do is move towards the front of the card. Now we're going to invert the colors. So what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to drag another square, but it's going to be in this nice bright blue color. We're going to go ahead and lock that as well, like we did with the first one. So what I'm going to do is bring over this typeface over here. So we're going to copy this by pressing that button. We're going to go move over to this one and paste it in. We're going to change the color, and we're going to invert the colors all the way around. So instead of changing the font, I'm going to go to the fill, and we're going to choose this nice dark color there. Now, obviously, we don't want the logotype to be dead center. We're going to actually bring this down here. We may even get rid of this later on, but I'm going to be using this type as the information on my business card. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this again over to the top. And then from here, I'm going to change my name in there to my actual name, Will. Now, if this happens to you, all you need to do is use the bounding box like so to move it. We're going to go ahead and change the character style and the justification by going to the text. Make sure the justification is to the left. We want all our text to be aligned to the left. Now for this, I'm going to go ahead and reduce opacity by clicking this button here and just scrolling to the left, because we don't really want to use that for now. I'm going to go to the layers as well, and we're going to go ahead and lock that so we don't mess around with it for now. We're going to change it later. The main part of a business card is your name, information, so your contact info, your email, your number, and what you do. So for me, I'm going to go ahead and write in some of my information, but the way that we do it is really important. I'm going to show you a very minimal and simplistic layout for this. We're going to first of all change my text size a little bit. I'm imagining within these guides here, I can see what I'm designing. This is how the business card's going to look when it comes out. Now I'm positioning my name a bit further down from the top, and I want it to be sort of in the center. This gives a nice sort of margin over here and up here, so it doesn't look like it's right in the corner once it's been printed. Now, a little easy trick inside a vectornator is to go ahead and select this, and we're going to press this button over on the left. What this does is it allows us to go ahead and copy the text or any shape down or wherever we move it. Switch the button off, and then I'm going to change the text size to something smaller. Now, the first design principle here is contrast and hierarchy. We need our name, that's the most important thing for people to remember us. But then we also need some information in here. So I'm going to go ahead and write in a fake number. There's my fake mobile number. Now I've got my number, you can see the bounding box is pretty crazy. A little trick for anyone that struggles with these bounding boxes and getting them exactly where they should be is to go to the style, make sure you've got the text options open, and we're going to go to fit bounds to text size. And what we're going to do is we're going to shove it just here for now. The best thing to do is get all your information out straight away. Now we're going to repeat the copying process because we want to use this, but I'm going to change the weight to something less bold to give it more contrast. Click this button here and we can drag this down again, and we're just aligning them to the left for now. In this one, I'm going to put a fake email. Then we're going to copy it one more time because the website is an important part too. Boom, we've got our website. Now, this looks pretty boring. We need to add some other things in here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just hide the logo type for now because I don't think I'll be using it on the back. I wanna keep it as clean and minimal as possible. But something that we can do, and in Vectornator is simple to do, is add icons like imageries, but we don't wanna be spending time on creating these icons. So what we wanna do is go ahead and create some space. Let's go ahead and create some space using the guides. It'll keep it in a nice order for us. We're going to move all this information to the right slightly, and then we're going to go up here. We're going to press this button there and go to Iconator. What this does is it gives you access to over 80,000 free use icons. So first of all, I'm going to say mobile. Go ahead. I'm going to look for the best icon here. I'm going to choose this one. I'm going to hold it, drag it over, group them and scale it down. And as easy as that, we have got icons straight into Vectornator. These icons work really well. It gives a bit more of context to what the information is to the right, as well as it fills in the information on the left. Otherwise, it'll look a bit bare bones. The next one I'm going to do is mail. So just type in mail. Let's find a good one that looks like a nice mail icon. We're going to choose this one, I think. Yep, I like the look. Go ahead, group it, scale it down to a similar size. Make sure it's in the same alignment as the last one, which is about here. And the last one is website. So we're going to type in website. You can see how simple this is. Scroll down, have a look if there's anything that takes a fancy in here. Choose this one, group it again, scale it down, and holding my finger, this constrains the actual shape. If I didn't have my finger there, you could mess around with the shape and it would warp it. Holding this down constrains it. We'll go ahead, select all these icons, go to arrange, make sure that all horizontally aligned. So from here, I'm going to go ahead and select them all and move them to the left. What we're looking for is this guide to match with this W here. We want everything and all the information to be exactly where they should be on the left. This is guiding, and you can do this with grids if you want, but I find it a bit easier not using grids all the time. Now our information here is pretty large. So what I'm gonna do is select everything and we're going to scale this down ever so slightly. Now that I've got my information in there, what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and outline it. If you're printing this out of printers, outlining your text is really important because they may not have the font file that you have. And when you create outlines from these texts, it allows the printers to be able to print it from shapes instead. So press outlines. I'm gonna go ahead and group all these together and scale them down ever so slightly and move it into a nice position. So we've got our information right there, clean and simple. The next thing I want to do is add more of what is on the front here, but in the reverse. So I'm going to go ahead and press my pencil tool. Make sure that the smoothness is all the way to the top. If the smoothness isn't at the top, you'll get some weird lines. And what we're going to do is play around with some ideas of shapes in this quadrant down here. From here, I'm going to go ahead and play a bit more with the spacing. What I'm looking for is an even distribution of space. So I want it in grids. Now what we have is a business card that's ready to go. It looks a bit strange right now because it's still got the bleed at the end. This is where the cutoff is going to be, where the printers will cut the card. So everything in this guide is where you're gonna actually see the design. That is how you create a business card inside of Vectornator. If you'd like to learn more about how to design inside of Vectornator, subscribe to this channel and I'll see you in the next one. See you soon, goodbye.